Philippine Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri postpones hearings with their fellow lawmakers in the lower chamber on the approved constitutional convention bill. Zubiri says he has asked to meet with House Speaker Martin Romualdez first before the Senate panel can call in House members. He has also asked Senator Robin Padilla, the chairman of the Senate Committee on Constitutional Amendments, to hold off his invites for the discussions of the bill.
We heed the call of Congressman Elpidio Barzaga for a ceasefire in the heated discussions on charter change, calling instead for the leadership of both houses of Congress to hold a caucus where we can have a productive discussion on the matter, rather than everyone airing their grievances in public. This is the reason why I asked Senator Robin Hood Padilla to postpone his invitation to our representatives as resource persons. Let me clarify. Traditionally, the Senate does not invite incumbent members of Congress as resource persons, as they are accorded inter-parliamentary courtesy, being members of a co-equal branch of legislation. We usually invite representatives of the House as guests, not as resource persons, particularly on discussions, these discussions of controversial matters. We invite the House of Representatives as guests during the hearings of their local bills.
The Philippine government's chief lawyer refutes a remark by the former police chief who oversaw the Duterte administration's drug war. Solicitor General Minardo Guevara says he does not believe an arrest warrant from the ICC related to the drug campaign will lead to a conflict, as suggested by now Senator Ronald De La Rosa.
Hindi naman siguro mahuhuli sa gera, no? Kaya lamang nandun talaga yung posibilidad na yun kung paano mo i-enforce yung ganyang warrant of arrest. Kasi wala namang sariling law enforcement agency ang ICC at sila ay aasamin sa mga pamahalaan ng kanilang member agency para sa enforcement ng warrant. Kasi kung hindi makikipag-cooperate yung government, ay mahihirapan din ang ICC.
The National Economic and Development Authority releases the implementing rules and regulations for the Public Service Act. The measure allows full foreign ownership in the airport, expressway, railway, and telecommunications industries. The IRR also includes provisions to safeguard the country from dubious acquisitions, mergers, and public service investments. In a statement, NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan called the act a landmark reform that could potentially attract more foreign investments. The PSA will take effect on April 4, 2023. The Sugar Regulatory Administration says Malacañang has approved the selling of smuggled sugar in Kadiwa stores. Jervis Manahan joins us on the line for more. Jervis?
Yes, Ron, smuggled sugar will soon find its way to Kadiwa stores of the Department of Agriculture after SRA's announcement that the palace has approved the plan to sell the sugar instead of condemning them. This comes after DAC's 780,000 kilos of smuggled sugar in the port of Subic last week. SRA board member Pablo Luis Ascona told reporters that the smuggled sugar will be sold at around 70 pesos per kilo, lower than the retail price of sugar in most wet markets. Ascona said that they have observed smugglers bring sugar to the country whenever there is an ongoing import program. He said there were instances legitimate importers used permits twice in what he called as technical smuggling. He also said that some smugglers used the opportunity to confuse port officials if smuggled sugar can pass as legitimately imported sugar. In this case, the SRA official said that if smuggled sugar will remain at the custody of the Bureau of Customs, the only options would be destroying it or auctioning it, in which case the same smuggler bids to get the sugar back. As Gona said, the decision to sell sugar in Kadiwa is a good effort, so at the very least, consumers will benefit from it. It is still uncertain as to when will the smuggled sugar be available in Kadiwa stores. Ron.
Jervis Manan with that story. Thanks, Jervis.